In the Bible, we find one of the most beautiful appeal from God. It says, "Today, if you hear His voice, harden not your heart." Would you like to spend this day with God? Listen to this devotional.
This Day with God, a devotional by Ellen G. White. Guard the approaches. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. Psalm 126, verses 5 and 6. Many times, we James and Ellen White are disappointed in our expectations. But then when we see the Lord working with our efforts and souls coming to Christ, we forget the weariness, disappointments, and trials which we meet in connection with this work and feel honored of God to be permitted to have a part in it. We have had some very precious seasons of prayer with some who were discouraged and almost in despair in a camp meeting held in Iowa. We rejoiced with them as light shone into the darkened chambers of the soul. The Lord has indeed encouraged our hearts and strengthened us for our great work. We do believe fruit will abound to the glory of God as a result of this meeting. Let your prayers, my children, Edson and Emma, go up to heaven in our behalf, that God would bring souls who are in the darkness of error to the knowledge of the truth. Light, precious light, is shining on every page of the Word of God. It is the man of our counsel. When we study its pages with a heartfelt desire to learn our duty, angels are close beside us to impress the mind and strengthen the imagination to discern the sacred things revealed in the Word of God. Every thought, word, and act we should bring to the test of God's revealed will. In all things, the inquiry should be, will this please God? Will it be in accordance with the teachings of His Word? And when there is an indecision of mind in regard to duty, our natural hearts will plead for indulgence to follow inclination. But let us ever take the safe course, however much self-denial it may involve. Let us be determined to run no risk where eternal interests are involved. Dear son Edson, guard faithfully your thoughts. Keep every approach to your heart well fortified. You must put up the bars against the approach of Satan. Watchfulness at one point while others are neglected will not avail. The careless neglect on one sentinel will imperil the entire army. The neglect to guard one path to the fortress may prove the loss of the city. There are perils before us which we must meet, and our only safety is in God.